What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Footballers. And today's video, we're going to be unboxing the Under Armour Hammer MC in white and silver. So I don't know about you guys, but I've literally never even heard of these cleats before. So when I'm doing like my top lineman cleats, when everyone thinks of Under Armour, they're looking at like the Under Armour highlights. You're looking at like the Nike Force Savage. And a couple days ago, I was literally scrolling through East Bay's website and I clicked on like the lineman cleat section. I was like, yeah, Force Savage, Jordan 10, all this kind of stuff. And then at the bottom, I saw these, and I've literally never even heard of these before. I don't know how old they are. They're still on East Bay's website. I thought they looked really unique, and I was like, these might be a dark horse best lineman cleat that no one even knows about. Now, you're gonna wanna stick around all the way till the end of the video because I talk about something that I think actually really separates these cleats, and it's gonna be a huge preview before the review actually drops. Today, we're unboxing the Under Armour Hammers. All right, so let's kick off the unboxing here. And as I open this up, you know, with like cleats, there's not a ton going on unless you're getting one of those like super special packages where you're paying like a lot of extra money for the cleats. You're just not getting like a crazy unboxing experience when it comes to football stuff, at least in the current state. Now, when you first open the packaging on these cleats, you might actually think to yourself like, did I accidentally order a pair of basketball shoes? And when you look at these from a first glance, you're like, oh damn, they accidentally sent me a pair of Curries. And it's like, you can't even figure out what this thing is. So let's just talk through a couple, you know, my first impressions when I pick up and I hold this cleat. So on the bottom here, you have a traction plate that kind of looks like no other one on the market here. And you can see the reason being is they've put a lot of not triangle studs like other companies, not circle studs, but they've done square studs all around the perimeter. They have two toe studs at the front, and then they have a couple of these smaller like triangle pyramids in the middle. Four more at the back. Now, this is actually really intriguing to me off the bat because it's like nothing we've ever seen. Now, when you flip the cleat over though, when you're looking at it, you're like, okay, it doesn't have a crazy traction plate, but you know, cause they're pulling from, it looks like basketball here. It has a really nice cushy looking midsole. Now, I don't know how much it actually carries all the way through the cleat and testing, but that's something we will find out more about. Now, when you're looking at the upper on this cleat, I kind of see it in like three different pieces. So number one piece, you have this like front rubber material that's like super grippy, which I don't really know about. And I thought from like my first impressions, it's gonna be really good for protection, but I'm not 100% sure. The reason being is when you look under it, you can see a ton of ventilation, which is really nice, don't get me wrong, but I just don't know about the protection element. Around the laces as well, it looks like the laces are kind of tucked in, so maybe a little bit less risk of them getting cut or clipped. However, the fronts are still completely exposed. And there's no straps, there's no anything extra like that. It's just a pure lacing system like you would get with a basketball shoe. Now, looking inside the cleat, there's actually some pretty cool stuff going on in here. It feels really nice. It feels like a really thick padding on here. It feels really comfortable and cushy. There are no dedicated Achilles pads in here like you have in some other cleats, but overall, it feels like a good thickness so far. Taking out the insole here, you can actually see on the bottom, it's not like a fabric material. It actually feels more rubber-like. Although it looks like this insole has these grooves in it, so it sits in a specific spot. When I looked inside, it doesn't look like it actually matches up. Now, the thing that surprised me the most when I pulled these out of the box was actually gonna be the weight. These things weigh nothing. When I've been picking up Nike Force Savages and Elite TDs and all these other really heavy cleats all the time, picking these up, it felt like I was literally putting nothing on my feet. Going into that, I did try them on and they actually felt decent. They felt like a basketball shoe that was slightly too big for me. Normally in Nike basketball shoes, I actually do wear a 12.5. These are a 12.5. So it could just be Under Armour that Under Armour fits slightly differently and maybe I needed to size down slightly. But you know, side to side, it feels okay. Off the bat, it doesn't feel like I'm crazy locked in, and that just could be the lacing I need to tighten up more. Again, this is stuff that'll all happen with testing. You can see here, I'm actually doing like a little bit of like a toe test, and it doesn't feel like there is a ton of protection on your toes, which I was kind of disappointed in, but who knows? We're gonna go test these. We're gonna go do a bunch of drills with these out in the field. We're gonna put them through the paces as much as I can and predict how these materials will hold up over time. But again, those are things that'll all happen in the actual review. So there you guys go. And don't forget, thank you East Bay for sending these out to me, guys. They will be linked in the description down below if you want to pick them up before the review does drop. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to subscribe as we put out two videos every single week. Thanks for watching.